Close your eyes and breathe in and out. Feel the oxygen rushing into your lungs with every breath. Now take it all away. What happened to the green environment that you see? Did they burst into flames from the dry, intense heat from the beating sun? Did the birds stop singing because they flew somewhere else to survive? Is the oxygen you're breathing clean, or is it making it harder for you to breathe? Now open your eyes and take note of the possibility that could turn into a reality. These are the effects of global warming. The world as we know it will change, and not for the better. If you're thinking, well, we still have time, why can't we deal with it later? Think again. Right now is the best time to seize the challenge of at least implementing a solution to fixing this problem that will affect this generation and the generations following. As we wait and continue to ignore the problem, not only will these proposed solutions grow more costly, but we will have even less time to put them into action and a far lower chance of helping our current situation. Many studies conducted by trusted sources including NASA and globalchange.gov have shared scientific facts about why this has been such a magnified problem, especially in recent years. Our current CO2 levels have reached the highest they've ever been at 411 parts per million. The global temperature has gone up to 1.9 degrees. Arctic ice and ice sheets have been drastically melting at 12.8% per decade and at 413 gigatons per year. Sea levels have been rising by 3.3 millimeters per year, which is enough for cities like New York and most in Florida, such as Miami, Fort Lauderdale, Coral Springs, etc., at risk of being completely flooded in years soon to come. In 2002, the entire Earth was just at 365 parts of carbon dioxide per million, but in 2016, the world has reached at least 405 to 415 parts per million, and all countries are covered by it. All countries will experience the devastating effects of climate change, not just America, not just Africa or China or Latin America. Everything and everyone can and will be wrapped up in this crisis. The major causes of the buildup of carbon dioxide and other greenhouse gases in our atmosphere are plastics, fossil fuels, and livestock, even though this is a natural process for them. There are many different ways that we, as a society, can approach this and make sure that we can live a more efficient and safer quality of life, while also helping the earth that has allowed for us to live at all. A researcher at the University of Hawaii, Sarah Jean Royer, discovered that plastics release methane and ethylene into the air when exposed to sunlight. Both of these gases are powerful contributors to global warming, and the worst of all plastics is known as LDPE. This is because it is the most produced, consumed, and discarded plastic that we use in our daily lives. Royer gives some examples of what this plastic is used for. Quote, the rings around the beer cans, some forks and knives that are being used in restaurants, and some kinds of plastic bags as well, end quote.
My name is Maya Limas.
Hello, my name is Angela Nienes, and welcome to Mad News, coming live from Lancaster, California.
It's Tuesday, June 4th. And greenhouse gases are one of the leading causes of global warming.
Well, first we have to see our evidence and what our experts have to say about greenhouse gases. Should we stop getting ahead of ourselves, or should we start worrying about this place we call home?
We have some experts willing to share their thoughts and evidence on why global warming is such a big problem.
Take it away, Penny.
What are your thoughts on how greenhouse gases affect global warming?
Oh, I already answered these. Greenhouse gases absolutely affect global warming. Global warming, it's melting our polar ice caps, and it's going to raise the sea level. So, yeah, a lot.
How has global warming or greenhouse gases affected our planet?
It's definitely changed the weather patterns. I think people think of global warming means everything's going to get hotter. I don't think that's exactly what global warming means. I just think it's changing the normal weather patterns. And also, as I said, the polar ice caps are melting, which is going to make a lot of animals extinct. And and raise our sea level.
At this rate, do you believe humans can damage the Earth drastically?
I think we already have damaged the Earth drastically.
How has the air quality changed over the years?
I mean, I come from Minnesota, right? So it's not, there's not a lot of pollution. And so you would think it's cloudy, but it's not cloudy out here. It's smoggy, which is like all the exhaust from the cars. Sometimes over in I used to live over in San Bernardino County, and you could like see the smog, like when you went up towards Victorville, you could see the smog. It's just disgusting.
How has greenhouse gases affected climate change?
I don't know, to be honest. Like, I have no idea. Maybe the fires, is that part of greenhouse gases? Like all the fires? I don't really have a great explanation. I don't want to make something up.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Okay.
Thank you.
Yep.
What are your thoughts on how greenhouse gases affect global warming?
The facts are that greenhouse gases do affect global warming. They cause like a thicker blanket around our planet, which traps heat, and that causes our Earth's temperature to change. It causes ice to melt. It causes the jet stream to be affected so that storms don't push through and they cause more destruction. So the facts are there.
How has the changes in global warming affected our planet?
Well, there's an article and it talks about how many more species will be extinct in the next, you know, I don't know, 10 years. And so we've had massive extinction. We have species that are trying to adapt, but the change is so fast that it's hard for them to do so. We have people that still are drinking polluted water. We have around our planet famine because of droughts, and so we have now people migrating to other places to escape, and that gives us another set of social and economic issues. So it's definitely had a huge impact on our planet.
At this rate, do you believe humans can damage the Earth drastically?
They have, yes, absolutely.
How has air quality changed over the years?
Well, this has to do with increased CO2, but also increased toxins that are emitted due to industry. And so not only do you have an increased level of greenhouse gases, but you also have more pollutants that are not just greenhouse gases.
Do you think climate change could be irreversible at this day and age?
Well, I think we have to do our best to minimize its impact, to try to clean our air, to invest in cleaner energy. And I think it is the most important topic of your generation.
Thank you.
What do you say about that?
Well, that was very informational, but is that the only truth?
We have some more experts willing to share their points of views on the argument of greenhouse gases.
Okay, what are your thoughts on how greenhouse gases has contributed to global warming?
I think that the increase in greenhouse gases has been exaggerated because there's a natural warming cycle to the Earth that shows for billions of years we go through this cycle, but it is still being contributed to by people, but I think that the effect is exploited.
How has global warming or the process of greenhouse gases affected our planet?
Has affected our what?
Planet.
Well, it's causing a warming trend, and that's, again, the natural cycle. We're going to get warm to a point that the ocean currents are going to stop, and then when the ocean currents stop, it gets really, really warm, and then it drops off, and again, we go into an ice age. And then we'll go into an ice age for 10,000 years, and then we'll warm up again, and then we'll go back into an ice age for 10,000 years. It's part of the natural cycle of the Earth.
At this rate, do you believe humans can damage or not damage the Earth?
I think that we are constantly damaging the earth in a lot worse ways than by our cars.
How has the air quality changed over the years?
There's a lot more pollution in the air and a lot less trees, which means less pollution is being filtered out of the air. So that's our biggest problem, is the removal of trees, not the increase of carbon dioxide. The amount of carbon dioxide is relatively stable.
Why don't people believe in global warming?
Denial, they don't want to give up certain things that they have. And then people want to blame things that don't make sense. Like they say it's all the cow's fault. Well, 100 years ago, there were 10 million buffalo roaming in the United States, and that's a lot more than there are cows now, but now it's the cow's fault. Like, it doesn't make any sense. So people just like to use a scapegoat, and they don't want to give up things that they have.
Mm. Do you think climate change could be irreversible?
I think it is irreversible. We've already set a certain path in motion, and it's part of the natural cycle of the Earth. So it's going to happen. No matter what, the question is, how fast is it going to happen? So the less we take care of the earth, the faster it happens. The more trees we cut down, the less plants we have to filter those things out, the faster these things happen. And then, of course, carbon emissions from our cars contribute to it, but not at the level that people make you think.
Thank you. What are your thoughts on how greenhouse gases has affected global warming?
So greenhouse gases are part of why the climate on Earth is sustainable and why we can actually live in it, because without those greenhouse gases trapping some of the energy in, the Earth would be super cold, right? People believe that carbon dioxide is a global warming contributor, but carbon dioxide is required for human life, like our respiration and the way that plants grow and that type of side of things. Water is probably the number one greenhouse gas. And so if you look at what is causing global warming, it's really hard to say what one thing is causing it. And I don't think it would be from carbon dioxide. There's other more powerful contributors than that.
How has global warming or the effect of greenhouse gases affected our planet?
So with warmer temperatures and more carbon dioxide, plants are actually growing at higher latitudes. So we're actually able to grow crops for more people in places that used to be unsustainable to be able to grow wheat and corn and different things that feed the world. And so by being able to have a little bit warmer temperature with more carbon dioxide, we're actually providing more food for the entire world.
At this rate, do you think the Earth can be damaged drastically?
Yes and no. I don't think it's in the way that people think it's going to be. The higher temperatures and the issues with what people consider the problems, the ice caps melting and glaciers melting, and that we're going to see sea levels rise dramatically, I don't think that's going to happen, just because there's other factors involved with the way that the oceans, the ocean cycles and the water cycle of rain and clouds and that type of stuff. But the way that it could still damage the Earth is probably more in the way that we are thinking that it's going to do something that's not.
Has the air quality changed over the years, and how has it changed?
When I was a kid growing up, there was way more smog than there is now, and we've actually done a really good job of changing the way our cars and other transportation devices release the fumes and the other contaminants from the burning of gasoline. And so there's way less smog in LA and way less smog in the Inland Empire, like outside Riverside and San Bernardino, because we've been able to control those things. Worldwide, I don't know if that's been changed or not. I haven't really looked into that, but there's definitely less atmospheric issues and people are able to breathe a little bit better in the LA area because of the changes we've made in the last 25 years.
Why don't people believe in global warming?
I don't know. I understand your question. Why do they not believe in it? I didn't know that it was something that needed to be believed. It's not a religion, is it?
Yeah, it's not a religion, but some people say that they don't believe in global. Like they say they don't believe in global warming.
Okay, I think I know where you're trying to go with that. The main thing that I have an issue with is when people say, the temperature has increased by this number of degrees. Well, what are we comparing that temperature increase to? What is normal? is normal 1938, when all of the records in the United States were set for the highest temperatures ever. Because then it's like about the same, maybe even gone down a little bit. But if you go for like the 1960s and 70s when it was cold, then yeah, you're going to see warm. If you take an average over the last, I don't know, 200 years, like from when we started keeping records, then we're a little bit up. But even then is an increase of 0.2 degrees Celsius. So it went from 15.8 to 16 degrees Celsius, which is like 58 to 59 degrees Fahrenheit. Maybe a little more. I might be off on my numbers there. But is it a 1 or 2 degrees temperature difference in the entire world? Is it that big of a change? To say I don't believe in global warming is to not look at the numbers, but we have to still say, what are we comparing those numbers to?
Do you believe, if we have climate change, that it could be irreversible?
I believe that the Earth's climate is in a continuous flux, like it's always changing. There's been ice ages and hot periods and ice ages and hot periods, and so I don't think that it's irreversible. I think it's going to reverse on its own. I think it's going to be a constant up and down, and we're going to have to watch and see. And that's the good news, is Earth's been here a lot longer than we have.
Thank you. That's all the questions. I think I understand it a little more now. Huh, Maya?
Yeah, it's good to have everyone's different opinions on things, or else how will we know who's right?
Like the bagel you took from me.
Let's not talk about that right now.
Right. Well, I believe we have some more experts and what they have to say about greenhouse gases.
Take it away, Penny.
It's a monologue.
What are your thoughts on how greenhouse gases has affected global warming?
Well, I've been around a long time. I think actually climate change, I think, is something that's always happening. It's been happening since the days of the dinosaur. It's just a natural thing that happens because climate, nothing in the world is forever. You know, everything's temporary, everything's always changing. Okay, so first of all, so climate change, I think, is actually very normal. Okay, but the global warming thing, in my research, I have found more for the side of nothing to really be alarmed about right now. That the changes, the amount of water that is, like the polar ice caps and all that stuff, the amount of water that actually is being added to our oceans would be the equivalent of, gosh, I can't even think of the right measure, but it's like so minute that it's nothing really to be all worried about. So I'm not too alarmed about it. And there's documentation out there to support that. I'm just not thinking of it right now. So anyway.
How has the effect of greenhouse gases affected our planet in everyday?
Greenhouse gases do affect, but carbon dioxide, I believe, is a greenhouse gas. And trees use it, you know? So I have a way of thinking, maybe I'm a little too happy-go-lucky with the whole thing and not alarmed enough. But I'm just kind of chill about it. I think nature has a way of taking care of itself. And of course, we don't need to keep flooding it, you know, with like chemicals and things like that. But I actually think our world today is cleaner than it was back in the 1960s and 70s. I can remember driving in the car, going over, I grew up in Simi Valley, going over the hill into the San Fernando Valley and just seeing the smog. It was a regular occurrence. It happened all the time. Just the thick smog. I mean, LA was a whole different color back then, you know? And you don't see that anymore now. Between catalytic converters that came on scene like mid-70s, I guess, and, you know, like the legislation that's come since that time to clean up LA area and like other major cities around our country. I mean, I think actually our world today is much cleaner than it was, you know, like 40, 45 years ago. So, but you know, that happens because of like environmental pioneers. So we need them, you know, like it starts with lovely people like you doing the interviews like this. Yeah.
At this rate, do you believe humans can damage the planet?
I think damage would be the wrong word. I tend to think, because I'm of more the Christian view, that life is here, all of life and all of creation is here for us to enjoy it. You know, some people have the wrong idea. They think enjoying is destroying it or damaging it, and that's wrong.
But I think we have a responsibility to use what God's given us in a way that's going to also keep other people in mind, you know, and, you know, making sure that we leave, you know, we all have a carbon footprint, we all do. But I think, you know, if we are mindful of generations yet to come that and compassionate for what kind of world that they're coming into, I think of my granddaughter, you know, then I think we'll all just be just fine. Beyond, ours is not just the Milky Way is like only one small universe in the whole big scheme of things, you know. So I think we have plenty of space out there to explore and to, you know, not consume, but to enjoy.
How has the air quality, as you've seen, changed over the years?
It's gotten better. It's gotten much better. I just wish that we'd stop the wind in the Antelope Valley. I'm done.
Why do people believe in global warming?
People believe in global warming because I think mostly it's out of a concern for the future, and it's out of a compassion for future generations that have yet to come here. I think it really is born out of you know, a heartfelt response for other people, you know, that have yet to be coming here.
Do you think any of it would be irreversible?
I do think some of it's irreversible, but I think a larger amount of it is fixable. And I think that nature has a way of repairing herself, if I may say that, personification. And I know that you know, technology is leading us in ways where we can clean up our mess. You know, a lot of the water mains are like over 100 years old down there. And when they go, it's because, but then they're replaced with, when they go, it's because they're made of older materials, you know. But then they're repaired, and like we have the newer technology that repairs it. So I think our world actually is getting better and better. I really do. I think there's a lot of people that would disagree with me, but I enjoy life. They do too. Okay.
Thank you.
Looks like that's all we have for today.
Well, should we be afraid or not?
Well, that's for our audience to decide. We just give them reliable information to help out with that.
This was Mad News reporting from Lancaster, California.
Thank you for watching.
There are many safe substitutes for plastics like LDPE that include clay, glass, ceramics, and linoleum. There are also many ways to spread the word on how dangerous these things really are and how badly they're affecting our planet. You can host or join events like the Ocean Cleanup or start your own recycling business like this 7-year-old boy, Ryan Hickman, whose passion is to recycle and to protect the ocean from the harmful plastic that we use. Not only is it relatively easy, you can make sure that plastic that comes your way actually gets recycled while making money for doing something great. The biggest challenge that needs to be faced in order to overcome climate change is reducing the use of fossil fuels and electricity. This is probably the most difficult cause that we have to change because it's so normal to use airplanes, cars, and things in our own homes like heaters, ovens, and so on. It's a modern way of living now, and some, or even most people, won't be willing to change because it's so efficient. There are already systems like solar panels that are reducing the amount of carbon dioxide that we put on, but that amount is still doing harm. The EPA is already working on plans to reduce the carbon footprint of transportation, which includes the light-duty and heavy-duty GHG regulations. Heavy-duty GHG regulations are to reduce CO2 emissions by about 270 million metric tons over the life of vehicles built under the program, saving about 530 million barrels of oil, and the proposed Phase 2 program includes standards that would further reduce GHG emissions and improve the fuel efficiency of medium and heavy-duty trucks. These are two amazing plans that will only not ensure that we can begin to fight the good fight, but to also ensure that we have a future. Quote, so what do? Anything. Something. So long as we just don't sit there. If we screw it up, start over. Try something else. If we wait until we satisfy all the uncertainties, it may be too late. End quote. This is said by Lee Iacocca, a Ford developer. This is one of my favorite quotes by Lee Iacocca, the developer of Ford, because it inspires me to try. It can also inspire all of us to try, to try and come together, to try to beat climate change before it's too late. We need to take a stand. It will be difficult, and there will be bumps in the road, but why not just try? For ourselves and for our planet Earth.